James Harden did not report to training camp yesterday because of the NBA's COVID-19 protocols. Harden posted pictures on IG over the weekend celebrating Lil Baby's birthday party without a face mask. Come on, James. Yesterday, his head coach spoke to the media about Harden's absence from camp.
As far as timetable, there is no timetable as far as I know. And it is a setback. You know, you want your best player to be here, and there is a short window. You have to be honest and understand that this is a setback, not having one of the best players in the NBA here.
Max, do you feel like this is all proof that Houston just needs to move Harden at this point?
Absolutely, yes. This is the leverage a superstar player has in the NBA. In the NBA, make no mistake, the superstars are in charge. Forget about the letter of the law. The superstars run the league. Guys, this is what the superstar can do on any NBA team. He can turn himself into a distressed asset. He can make it obvious that he don't want to be there. And let me tell you what happens to the team that has him. Like, here, the star's interests and the team's interests are diametrically opposed. How so? The team wants to get as much as they can for the superstar if they have to move him, and they know they have to if he doesn't want to play there. But that's not in the superstar's best interest. You don't want to gut the place you're going to, right? So the superstar could be fine with a strategy of, look, I'm going to make it very obvious I'm not happy here. And what the rest of the league knows is they're going to have to trade him anyway. Not only that, but if he has a short list, particularly if it's a list of one, everyone knows they're going to have to trade him to that team. And so what does that mean? His trade value goes down. In other words, not in terms of how great a player he is, but what you're going to go get back goes down. So I know the team is thinking, we haven't heard an offer we like yet. We can wait till the trade deadline, get the best possible offer. But the best possible offer you can get then is probably not going to be as good if you have an unhappy star who doesn't want to be there and is making that clear. The whole league knows we don't have to trade as much for him, and it depresses the value of what they can get back, making it in the team's best interest to get the best deal they possibly can as quickly as they possibly can.
I disagree with you, Max. And here's why I disagree with you, because James Harden, specifically according to the reports, said that he wants to go to one specific destination. Well, what you've done is you've hampered the team's ability to get equitable compensation in return for your services. And if you're Houston, you have no obligation to be complicit in that kind of maneuver. The fact of the matter is James Harden's getting about $41 million this year. He's going to be making like $44 million next year. Got a player option for $47 million after he took the money, he signed a contractual agreement. And that doesn't mean they shouldn't move him. I'm saying they should. But what I'm saying is you don't want to capitulate to that now, because what happens is everybody is going to try to get him on the cheap because they know how desperately he wants out. I am in total support of James Harden wanting out of Houston. I'm not in total support of how he is handling it. I in a perfect world, I want Stephen Silas to have James Harden. But I knew the minute that him and Russ couldn't coexist, even though I believe in John Wall and I think that John Wall is going to come back and wreak havoc, the fact of the matter is he's coming off that Achilles injury. And so we don't know what his health is going to be like. If you're wondering about Kevin Durant, Max, in terms of what Kevin Durant's going to be like, imagine what you could wonder about John Wall, because John Wall can't shoot like Kevin Durant. And so we've got that to be concerned about. And then you look at the powers in the West. Denver's gotten stronger. The Lakers are the champions. The Clippers are supposedly going to come back with a vengeance. You look at the Western Conference, the powers that be. Houston and Dallas's ascension with Luka and Porzingis once he gets healthy. Okay, now Houston is really, really dipped. So the window of championship opportunity is no longer there for James Harden. So absolutely, you move him, you trade him. But where he was not smart, in my estimation, is literally saying it's Brooklyn that I want to go to. To me, it should be Brooklyn or it should be Philadelphia. Either or works. The way Kyrie looks right now, you might want it to be Philly instead of Brooklyn. But all I'm saying is you've got to give Houston options. And because he didn't do that, Max, apparently reported, because I haven't spoken to James Harden, but because he did not do that and he really pigeonholed them by saying Brooklyn to now, and I believe that he was at the strip club on purpose. I don't think James Harden is a professional, man. He ain't doing something like that by accident. He did it to send the message he wants out. He did it so he would have an excuse not to show up the first day at training camp. But now that the cat's out the bag, it just illuminates the fact this brother desperately wants out of Houston. He wants out. He wants to be gone. And if that's the case, if you did it now, you're going to get him for cheap. If you're another team, in all likelihood, that's why if I'm Houston, I would wait a little while until I get the offer that I want for his services. I cannot lose James Harden for nothing. I got to get a big time asset.
What makes you
in
think you're going to get that offer?
Say what?
Look, I get the asset thing, but what? Yeah. But what makes you think you're going to get that offer? Unless the only way you can is if you really value certain teams' draft picks. They're not lottery protected.
Okay, so
whatever,
let's be specific.
Or
then.
They have extremely high draft picks. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Let's be specific. If it's Brooklyn, it should be Dinwiddie. It should be Caris LeVert. It should be numerous picks. If it's the Sixers, it should not be a deal that does not include Ben Simmons. Period.
Agreed. If I were the Rockets, I'd want to deal him to Philadelphia so I could get Ben Simmons. And I think Harden and Embiid would be a problem in the East. And then the Rockets would get back a genius, young, brilliant, 6'10", you know, franchise centerpiece. Because otherwise, you lose any deal you make. The question is, can the Brooklyn Nets, do they have enough assets to maneuver so they can get a piece that Houston wants? I'm just saying, Stephen A., the longer Houston waits, the worse the deal is going to get. It ain't going to get better.
So.
It's going to get worse. Because increasing the league... Increasingly, the league is going to know that's a distressed asset. It's an unhappy star.
I think the sooner they make a move, the worse the deal would be. But I will say this, because of Kyrie's position that we just talked about earlier, if I'm Brooklyn, it might be even more important than I get James Harden. Because guess what? You got to have something in that locker room to help KD. Because if KD's going to lose it if everybody comes to him asking him about Kyrie all the time. I'll tell you that right now. KD's going to be ready to hit somebody. I'm telling you right now. He's going to lose it.
What about Kyrie for
if everybody keep bugging him about Kyrie, he's going to lose it. But the person who would have done that was Kyrie.
All right. Max, interesting. We can't get into that. I heard that trade comment at the end. Harden has led the NBA in scoring the last three seasons. We might need to discuss that at a later date. When we come back here on First Take, much more to dive into. Fellas, why is LeBron, quote, hurt by Kyrie Irving? Wait till you hear what Kyrie had to say and how LeBron...